This is a painting of the Big Red Lighthouse in Holland, Michigan. As you can see from these pictures, we visited last night. And I chose this angle because I wanted the rocks in the foreground and the lighthouse. And if you look closely, just to the right of the lighthouse on the pier, you see a small bench, which my wife particularly thought that would be nice to sit on. Unfortunately, you can't get to that side. It's landlocked by private property. So you can see here, I'm sketching out the basic shapes. When you do these sort of loose line ink paintings, I guess it's not necessary to be too fussy on details. If you really truly try to do sketches and not full-blown drawings, or, you know, masterpieces, you can be a little more relaxed with it, and that's part of what I like to convey in these videos. Part of the reason I'm doing such a small painting, 5x5, is that it is just a sketch. It's not supposed to be a masterpiece or anything like that. I want you to have fun with the watercolors, get experience with mixing the paint on the paper, off the paper, working on your composition, picking colors that you really liked to stand out, and that sort of thing. Choosing shadows. One thing a lot of watercolor artists have trouble with is not getting a lot of contrast, and that would be in terms of color and in terms of darkness and lightness. You can see in the reference picture there that the pier that goes from the surface that the lighthouse is on down to the water is pretty dark. You'll see me messing with that. You'll see these pens here. I don't care what kind you get, as long as they're waterproof. Pointing at the sizes. This set has quite a few sizes from 0.01 up to 2 or 3. And I think I chose like a 0.04, 0.05. So at this point, I'm just going back in and drawing over my pencil drawing with the pen, which will bring out the basic composition and shape of everything. This style is kind of like coloring, where you draw the coloring book page and then you go fill it in. Of course, you could certainly do a painting like this without pen and ink, just a pencil, and then kind of do all of your work with the watercolor. Here I'm adding the name of the lighthouse and the date and my initials. Now we're ready to paint. You see, I have a small travel set of watercolors, and that's it's called a round brush. You see above my hand there's a larger round. I find that this size paintings, you don't really need anything much larger than this blue one I'm holding. And what you'll notice is I'm basically painting the sky area with clear water. And you might wonder why I'm waving that around. I'm looking at the sheen of the water on the paper. I want it to be kind of even and not excessively heavy or wet. Now I'm dropping in my reds. You can see me dabbing color off with the paper towel, adding a stronger color in there. Skies are a lot of fun. Sunsets. You can get a lot of nice transitions colors. You know, it takes practice and experience. I don't claim to be an expert, but the idea is that you just pick something that you like, and you get in there and you paint it. You do a drawing, you paint it. If you turn out with a really awesome painting, that's great. If it's not so great, that's okay too. You learn through experience with this kind of medium. You see me wiping the brush off of my fingertips. You can do that, of course. Be careful not to get paint all over everything. I used watercolor paint, so it should come off. You notice me painting over the railings. They're going to be a pretty dark blue at the end, so I think there's room for not having to mask that out or anything like that. And then I'm just taking a little stronger color and putting some streaks to some like the waves. I don't want to sit there and draw every single wave. Of course, I'm running this all at higher speed. You can see that I put some red in because the red is reflecting on the reference painting from the lighthouse. Doing this at a higher speed. Not so sure how I like it. I kind of like doing it at regular speed. It's a little more relaxed to talk about what's going on. But I know that not everybody has an hour to watch painting. So I'm trying this out. See how I like it. Rocks are fun. I'm not really painting them exactly the way they are on the reference. Again, this is your painting. If you want to highlight blue and yellow like I did, that's great. If you want to go with a more of a just regular gray, that's fine. I faded out because I went and used my hairdryer to dry things off, which is a good way to speed up your painting. Unfortunately, I'm learning about keeping my hand out of the way of the camera. There we go. And this is sped up even a little faster because I'm doing a lot of tedious lines to simulate the pier. And I'm probably going to spend a lot of time on that pier area, because it really anchors where the lighthouse is sitting. You'll also see me adding this dark line, because that even anchors it even more. If you don't do that, you end up with things that just kind of don't seem to have a place to sit. They all just kind of look like they're floating at the same level. So when you're doing watercolor, really any kind of painting, be cognizant of how dark you go and where you go dark. One of my early teachers said, don't be afraid to go dark. So I always talk about that when I do paintings. And I talk to others who are learning. Don't be afraid to go dark. And you see there, I actually mopped up some of the color and tried to make it more speckled. I just use the tip of the brush to spread some of those dots out so that they don't look so artificial. When you're doing rocks, you want to get dimension. You can see how I tend to darken up a certain side, left or right. So you see me putting a bunch of dots in there, and they look really horrible at the moment. But softening them up and spreading the paint out a little bit with the tip of that brush. Seems like I'm going really fast because it's probably at triple speed. But just take your time. Going back in and building up a little more layers in my water. Ooh, that's a pretty dark line. It's right on top of the railing, so I'm kind of cleaning it up, mopping it out. You can add a little water to your brush, paint it right back over, take a drier brush or squeeze the liquid out of a brush and mop it up. Now we're going to the lighthouse itself. pretty strong red. This lighthouse is called Big Red. Interesting fact about this lighthouse is that that big box at the bottom, I think it held a foghorn. So not all lighthouses have foghorns, but this one did, and I don't think they run the horn anymore. But the light is on. We saw the light as we left in the evening. It kind of went white, and it kind of went red. The paintings start to come together. So kind of what you're doing is you're laying in color. Sometimes you use the strength of watercolors and blending and bleeding. Sometimes you're just painting in solid panels of color. Sometimes you're doing a little bit of a mixture of those. Oh, look at that. I dropped my brush and I was able to clean up. Sometimes you'll do that and you'll get a big black splotch right in the middle of the sky, which can be very distressing. It could actually ruin a painting. That time, I was fortunate, it just landed in the water, and I'm going to be adding more color to the water area anyway. Using the smaller round has a pretty good tip on it. That is black. Again, you can see me trying to really define those rocks, make sure you can tell where they're separated. And then I go in and I kind of pull the color down into the field. You can see how I spread that out a little bit. You can add other colors or water to kind of, there you go, adding a little bit of water. It's called softening an edge. You can go in strong and then I'm now trying to get my color for that railing. This blue is a little stronger than the sky blue. You know, be careful at this point. You're kind of doing a detail that's going to be very noticeable. So make sure you get it. Take your time to get it in there. And I'm adding a little more. Well, I'm doing a little light wash over that area where the bench is. I don't want it to be pure white. I'm going to go and dry it off again. This whole painting took about an hour. It was a good time, a good amount of time for enjoying a painting project without making it too long and tedious. Again, this style is really appealing to people who want to do a project, get it done, don't want to have to come back to it, don't want to have to fret too much about the details. Texture and depth to the pier. A little brown in there. It's kind of a reddish brown. Compositionally, you kind of have a dark band at the bottom where the rocks are, a kind of a dark band in the middle. The water and the sky kind of sit above those. So that your eyes looking at it, it's noticing those dark and light streaks. If you squint, sometimes it'll help you see whether there's very much contrast. So I put some dark in there, but then I washed it out, and then I added it back in, trying to get a little bit of a shadow on the left side of that building, even adding some oranges. You can see we have some orange, probably dip in there and get some yellow. Trying to give it kind of a little feel, not that it's just all one straight color. Because even if something is a straight color, the lighting and so forth, the water's getting very dirty, it's time to change it. Look, it's nice and clean. Putting a little blue in the up where the light is. There's like three panels up there, and the middle one's gonna be it's gonna be the light. Again, not totally satisfied with the water yet. We'll add some more. Here we go. Still not satisfied with the pier. I'm pretty much adding a pretty dark streak at the bottom and top, and then I'm probably going to use some brown. And I'm kind of pulling the wet black from the top and wet black from the bottom together with the brown. Getting close to the end, I'm going to get drawn a little circle for the light. Found that it was wet, which wasn't a great decision, but here we are. Go and dry it off. Now I'm taking one of the thicker markers, and I feel like I want the lines to stand out a little bit more, particularly on the lighthouse. So I'm thickening that up. You can even go in and do some cross hatching if you want to build up some shadow with the marker. It's up to you, your painting. You can see it's standing up a little bit better now. Some of those lines on the rocks. And you can see me go in and do up and down scratching to really give it that feel of, you know, these are a bunch of pieces of wood or timbers. And by this time we have quite a bit of mixed color in there. We're getting close to the end. Hope you've enjoyed this painting of the Big Red Lighthouse on Ottawa Beach in Holland, Michigan. Again, just don't be afraid to pick something that you like. You can find a picture on the internet, or you can take a picture that you've use a picture that you've taken and just do a sketch and paint it in. You've enjoyed this video, and thank you for watching. Here's the finished product. Here's the finished product a little closer.